Any movement needs allies to become relevant, to be heard, to succeed. But for people from the LGBTQ community, that has never been easy. Many spend their lives looking for allies. But who are these allies, and how does allyship really work? Acts of hate against the LGBTQ community have been recorded across the globe. They can take many forms, including hate speech.
Do you think homosexuals should be sent to prison?
Yes.
Imprisonment, and even electric shock therapies.
Most queer people in India will be aware of the case of Harvey Malhotra. This young person, they committed suicide because they were mocked, derided, and actually abused by their peers for being effeminate.
February 16 को स्कूल बहुत खुश होके गया था, किसी को रिंग बांट रहा था, किसी को चॉकलेट्स दे रहा था. उसको पैनिक अटैक हुआ, दिल की धड़कन ऐसे हार्ट बीट इतनी तेज़ फास्ट हो जाना, और वो हार्ट बीट ना कंट्रोल नहीं होती थी आधे घंटे तक. उसको गे छक्का बोलना तो नॉर्मल था उन लोगों का. बाद में उसको पैंट पुल करके वॉशरूम में जब जाता था तो लड़कों का झुंड उसको आता था, और किसी ने पैंट पुल किया, किसी ने फेविकॉल डाल दिया पैंट के पीछे या आगे, किसी ने आंखों पे पट्टी बांधा, किसी ने कॉटन बॉल डाला कान में, किसी ने मास्टरबेट कर दिया उसके ऊपर. तो उसके बैग में सारी चीजें आज भी वैसी की वैसी पड़ी है, उसका स्कूल बैग. वो चॉकलेट्स कभी कभी मैं खा लेती हूँ उसको याद करते हुए.
This absence of allyship is a momentous thing, right? At an age when you need it most.
Harvey's death sent ripples across the LGBTQ community in India. It raised the question, what does allyship truly mean?
Allies are any person who is privileged, who acknowledges that privilege.
Who doesn't come from the LGBT community.
A champion, I think of a pillar of support.
And wishes to extend that privilege to people belonging to more marginalized or oppressed groups.
And he or she can help us get support and acceptance from the other members of the society.
A rock to stand by, to going to when the vicissitudes of life create storms that I alone can't withstand.
In 1977, Shakuntala Devi, the world-renowned mathematician, published a book titled The World of Homosexuals, which said, homosexuality is basically as old as humanity, but what is comparatively new and urgent is the need for contemporary society to come to terms in its thinking and its lawmaking, both with psychological knowledge and human behavior. As of 2018, it is no longer criminal to be a member of the LGBTQ community in India. So what exactly is it that stops people from calling themselves allies?
There is a very strong sense of what sexual relationships are. You know, sexuality is for procreation, and procreation, of course, only within a marital institutional framework. And therefore, any other kind of sexual proclivity is an indulgence that should not be, given space to.
Unfortunately, in India, we still lack that sex education from the parents, because they said they will spoil the children.
A lot of people question my sexuality and accuse me of being gay. They question that and they don't realize the harm in questioning that, because what they're questioning is my allyship. What I do is not an act of charity.
एक बच्चा बारी बारी बात लेकर के आता है तो उसी को ही प्रॉब्लमेटिक माना जाता है कि वाई ओनली ही इज कमिंग, वाई ओनली दिस पेरेंट इज टॉकिंग. उसको नेल पेंट से रोकना मीन्स उसकी सेक्सुअलिटी के लिए हार्म करना था, उसके लिए इयर रिंग पहन के मना करना आना मीन्स उसकी सेक्सुअलिटी को एक्सेप्ट ना करना था. शायद आप हैप्पी हो के अप्रिशिएट कर देते तो उसको लगता कि मुझे एक्सेप्ट कर लिया शायद से. मुझे कोई बोलता कि मैं सुंदर लग रहा हूँ, मुझे कोई बोल देता हूँ ये तो बहुत अच्छा आरवी आपने कैसे लगाया.
But sometimes even the best of allies get it wrong.
The best of allies can change rather quickly into demons that we'd rather not have as allies at our side.
When they take up the space that they were supposed to give and extend to the people of the marginalized groups.
But they come from behaviors that are sometimes condescending, sometimes stereotypical, sometimes just too simplistic.
So is that truly allyship when you are just using people of this community as a sort of clickbait to push your product?
Educate yourself. Even if you're educated, I have coined this word educated illiteracy. You may be highly educated, but you may not be literate about our issues.
From same-sex marriage, which is up for debate at the Supreme Court, to LGBT conversion therapy. People need to be aware of what the core issues are rather than just post vapid, vacuous images on Instagram or Twitter.
If they're faced with a hijra at a traffic light, then you're not able to make that connection that if I am a queer ally, then I should broaden my horizons to fold these in too.
This is just one degree of separation between me, a queer Dalit person who's here sitting as a doctor, and a queer Dalit person who's begging on trains. Just one degree of difference. So we need to change how we see queerness in itself. So let people who actually are from the marginalized groups do the talking. We can, because we have had no other option but to know these things by virtue of being this people.
मैंने वहाँ पौधे लगाए जो उसकी पसंद के थे. रोज़ जाती हूँ पानी देने और फिर वहाँ पर देखती हूँ कि जो फूल खिले होते हैं ना, तो मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि आरवी इज़ हैप्पी. कम्युनिटी के बच्चों से अब मिलती हूँ ना, तो वो उनकी चेहरे पे जो खुशी आती है ऐसे लगता है उनको देख के खुश हो जाती हूँ कि वो उनकी मदर से जो वो नहीं मिल पा रहा, शायद मैं एक पर्सन भी दे दूँ